You know, I'm pretty glad that I was wrong about the zombie horde structure deck. Not only is it a deck built on negation and disruption of the opponent, it abuses one of the most awesome cards in the game, Zombie World. You could say that if left unchecked, this deck can zombify your opponent and destroy their life points as well as their board presence entirely. I'm the Cali Effect, and if you guys want to see more videos like this, then go and destroy that subscribe button. But more importantly, go ahead and hit that notification bell because, well, we just too strong. Also want to give a special thanks to every single one of my Patreons. Without you guys, videos like this would not be possible. Also, a mad shout out to our newest Patreon, Charlie Connor. Make sure you add yourself to that Discord as well as message me or Jess so we can get you into the top dog session so you can take advantage of all your rewards. Without further ado, I present to you a competitive zombie deck profile for this format. And of course, we always have those budget options, and I have an insane combo to boot with this zombie strategy. Okay, so before we get into this deck profile, I have to talk about the stats. Looking at it, I think that zombies are really, really powerful. And if you ask me, it's one of those decks that could top a regional level event as it has done so before. As far as a YCS, I think with the new cards and Savage Strike, the Shiranui cards might give it a little bit of a boost. But for right now, I'm going to keep it at regionals. It does have some times where the consistency can be an issue, but the explosiveness, especially in this particular deck, is fun. So let's start off by talking about the monsters so we can get you well acclimated to what we play and how we play. We run two copies of Doom King Balardrok. He is insanely good. So if you control a field spell in your graveyard, you can special summon him to your side of the field. And if a zombie monster effect activate, of course, except for himself, you can either negate that monster effect or banish a monster on the field. Doom King Balardrok is insanely good. He is the board presence that allows you to not only get you negation but disruption. So I really like him. I wouldn't run more than two because opening him it's not really good. You want to send him to the graveyard or summon him to your side of the field. Next, we run one copy or two copies of Necro War Banshee. This girl is also insane. She protects Zombie World while she's on the field, but her more important effect is when she's in the graveyard, you can banish her to activate Zombie World. Now, as you guys seen in the live duel, you can actually get over quite a few cards. Like Notoria Beast can't stop Necro War Banshee from activating Zombie World, but keep in mind, cards like Anti-Spell Fragrance could stop Necro War Banshee. It's still a really powerful card, allowing you to get one of your most potent cards in your deck to your side of the field, and we take full advantage of it. Two copies of Globe Boom. Now, when I first read this card's effect, it was one of the first cards that I read inside of the structure deck. It's when it's sent to the graveyard, you can banish it to add a level 5 or higher zombie monster from your deck to your hand. And if you control Zombie World, you can special summon it. Immediately, what came to my mind was Ill Blood. And I still want to run that card because it is a level 6 zombie that pairs so well with the deck in my mind. Unfortunately, the use of that normal summon, I just can't give it up because Ill Blood does require your normal summon to pop off with its effect. That is the reason why I decided against it, but I really want to play Ill Blood. I'm going to try to play it if I get a secret rare. Next is three copies of Shiranui Solitaire. This card is insane for going into your Unizombie. If you guys ask me, I think that the Solitaire Unizombie ratio should always be 3-2, especially in this deck. While Unizombie is a powerful card, it becomes even more powerful when you can use Solitaire to get it to your field. One copy of Shiranui Spirit Master. This is a card that a lot of zombie players don't decide to play, but he is an excellent card. Not only does it destroy cards on your opponent's side of the field when it's banished, you can take full advantage of it with the new engine that I'm running. The new engine of that being is three copies of Revendred Slayer. Now, people are probably scratching your heads when you're looking at this. The next thing that came to mind with Glow of Bloom was, freak, I can search Revendred Slayer, even though I probably never do that. Revendred Slayer is insane. Not only can you continuously summon this 2400 attack monster to your side of the field, he also triggers your Shiranui monster's effect, which is the reason why we run Spirit Master. Another thing is that he gives us access to Beatrice, the Turtle Lady, which is really good for this deck. Being able to summon Beatrice is insane, ladies and gentlemen, because this deck loves to send monsters from the deck to the graveyard. One copy of Vendred Strigus. This card is really good, and I almost had a panic attack when I thought that you could use this card's effect multiple times in one turn. What happens is when it's sent to the graveyard, you can reveal a Vendred card in your hand and special summon it to your side of the field. It would have been insane to gain its effect multiple times in one turn to make some cool link and synchro boards. Next, only two copies of Unizombie. Again, I don't think that Unizombie is a card that you guys should play in multiples, and I like to stick to only five normal summons in this deck. This one actually runs six, so I'm not too happy about running six normal summons, but I still do think Unizombie is a really important card, probably one of the best cards in the deck, being able to tutor those zombie monsters to the graveyard and change its level. Two copies of Mizuki. Through testing and playing, I felt that only two Mizuki is necessary inside of this deck. It's not a card that you want to send to the graveyard immediately if you have other combos in mind. It'll sometimes be a brick inside of your hand, but drawing it actually does have a combo of its own when you draw your other brick in Unizombie and not drawing Solitaire. So I decided to run it. It's also a really good card for bringing those zombie monsters out. The card that I took out the third Mizuki for was with the Gozuki, and this is our other normal summon. It's not necessarily the best card ever since we have instant access to Beatrice, but it's still an insanely good card allowing you to send zombie monsters, and there's a combo with Unizombie Mizuki and Gozuki. Next for the monsters is one copy of Plex Spreader Zombie. You guys are probably scratching your head like, why Plex Spreader? Because it helps you make Synchro Sixes, which in turn, if you have to, sometimes you have to make Summon Sorceress, target one of your zombies, make the Plex Spreader, Synchro into your six, and then summon your Revengeance Slayer, and then you can make Beatrice. And then Beatrice sends to the graveyard, you can gain another special summon, and then, you know, go off from there. It's really good. I actually like Plex Spreader. It works really well with Vampire Sucker, because Sucker can always, you can bring it back, place the card to the top of your deck, bring it back, and Sucker allow you to draw that card, so it's basically a free summon. And then for the hand traps, we run two copies of Ghost Bell and Haunted Mansion, and two copies of Ash Blossom and Joyous Spring. For the people that can't afford Ghost Bells and Ash Blossoms, my strongest suggestion would be to play Effect Veilers, but if you guys want to get a little more saucy, Vampire Fallen is a card that I didn't think was great in this deck for the same reason that I didn't think Honest was good, but she can special summon herself to her side of the field at any given time and play her attacks on like Honest, so she has interaction during like any battle phase. She's not that bad. Another thing was another copy of Shiranui Spirit Master and the Shiranui Trap card, Shiranui Style Sword Slash, the one to banish the ones from the deck, because it can give you three destructions, and Vampire Falling can give you a little bit of protection. So I did think that those were very possible cards. So for people that can't afford Ash Blossoms and Ghost Bell, or just don't want to play Effect Veilers, those are some really good options for you guys. That's it for the monsters. For the spells, we run three copies of Zombie World. Best card of the deck. All monsters in the field become zombies. It's just really good at disrupting your opponent. Keep in mind that when you have this in Rivalry of the Warlords on the field, unlike what you guys saw in the live game, your opponent can't summon any more monsters. So it's like really bad for them. They can only basically control one monster at a time, where all of your monsters in your main deck are zombies, so you can continue to just summon them to your side of the field. Three copies of Pre-Preparation of Rites to search the Vengeance Slayer. And it's part of an insane combo, a two-card combo that will necessarily, like, you'll start off with five cards, but with two cards, you'll have six cards in hand, the Doom King Balardrock, Vampire Sucker, Beatrice, and a Zombie World. Revengeant Origin, that's the card that you target with pre-prep to search your, the Revengeant monster. And also, this card can actually be used outside of the combo to just bring out Slayer for free. And then Revengeant Evolution, this card sends Slayer to the deck to the graveyard to summon Slayer, so that's good. Three copies of Called by the Grave to stop my opponent from hand-trapping me. This is just insanely good. One for One was my extender of choice. You guys can run Monster Reborn or Soul Charge. I felt that Soul Charge wasn't that good inside of this deck because this deck does have a harder time setting up, so it is low-key a brick in your first hands, but it's amazing in any other time of the game. Super Polymerization, could not go without this card. Making my opponent's monsters into one of my monsters is fun. Foolish Burial, that is an extender, and then three copies of Rivalry of the Warlords. So the ruling with Rivalry of the Warlords is your opponent can't attempt to summon a monster with a different attribute than the one they already control, or a different type that they already control. If all monsters on the field are zombies, they can't go into their extra deck to summon a monster that is not a zombie. Even if Zombie World would make it into a zombie, it's not a zombie monster where they would be summoning it. Same thing with the hand. That's it for the main board, Let me show you guys the extra deck. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, so the extra deck consists of one Borreload and Borrel Sword Dragon. This deck does have a lot of room, so you can, if you can't afford these guys, you can just play Cherries targets and then just play Cherries in your main deck. You can play Effect Veilers and Cherries instead of Ghost Bells and excuse me, instead of Ghost Bells and Ash Blossoms. One Summon Sorceress, this card is mandatory to the deck if you ask me. It allows you to extend so many combos, but even more importantly, she becomes a zombie. So you can summon Sorka monster to your side of the field, and then use one of your other monsters if it's like, you know, not a problem. Or if you're summon Sorking Mizuki off a Plex Spreader and you make your six, you bring back the monster, and then you use summon Sork to go right back in a Vampire Sucker. Your Nightmare Package, which is Nightmare Phoenix, Cerberus, and Unicorn, just free destruction. And then Vampire Suckers. I actually ran three. You guys can run two. There are times where I'll go through two Vampire Suckers in one turn. So like I'll do the summon, I'll make the Vampire Sucker, then make the Summon Sorceress, then make Vampire Sucker again. And then it feels pretty naked to like not have another Vampire Sucker for the rest of the game. That's why I decided to run three, but I don't think that it's mandatory that you run three. It's really powerful card, allows you to draw cards anytime a monster is special summoned, allows you to special summon those or from the graveyard when your zombie monster is special summoned. It also allows you to special summon monsters to your opponent graveyard and use them as tribute. That tribute might come in handy if you play Frawling. One copy of Link Kribo, it's part of the two card combo to get Vampire Sucker and Balladrock. One copy of Beatrice the Eternal Lady, this is the Lady of the Hour. For the people that like want to run that Dante, you can cut the Summon Sorceress because when she's destroyed she summons Dante. Cypher Emerald Omega, best level 8 for this deck if you ask me. Stardust Charge Warrior, this is the best level 6 because upon its summon you get to draw a card. It's the reason why you'll have 6 cards in hand. Coral Dragon, this is a card that you actually could cut out as well. I felt that this deck needed two level 6s because that it plays two ways to synchro summon into 6, one being Unizombie, the other one being Plex Spreader. And Coral Dragon came up so much because it allows you to get Disruption and it allows you to draw a card when you go into Omega. It just felt so right inside of this deck. And then the Dragon Necro Nether Soul Dragon, for the Soul or Super Polymerization when you want to disrupt your opponent, fuse both of their monsters into a Dragon Necro and then keep playing Yu-Gi-Oh! That's it for the monster. Are the main deck and the extra deck. Let me show you these combos that I'm talking about because I'm telling you, they're sick. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, so these combos are relatively simple and there are so much more with zombies. The deck is just a really good combo-centric flow type deck, and I think you'll be able to find some that I've left hidden for you guys to find out when you play the deck. So this two card combo is gonna require Glow Bloom and Zombie World. What you're gonna do is activate the Zombie World to your side of the field and normal summon the Glow Bloom. Use the Glow Bloom for a link material into your Link Kribo and trigger the effect of Glow Bloom. This allows you to add a monster from your deck to your hand, but if you control Zombie World, you can special summon it. With that, you can special summon Doom King Balladrock to your side of the field. And take notice, since Zombie World is on the field, all your monsters on the field are zombies. So then you can use your Link Kribo and your Doom King Balladrock for a Link summon into your Vampire Sucker, only requiring two zombie monsters. During the standby phase, you can special summon Doom King Balladrock to your side of the field and proceed to draw a card. Now, this little two card combo got you, a Zombie World Vampire Sucker, Doom King Balladrock, and a free card from your deck to your hand. You can add it with any other extenders to draw a card on your turn, meaning that you would have had two cards in your hand, as well as this type of field and whatever your extender card was. Okay, so the next combo is the combo that I was talking about, the reason why I run the Gozuki. It helps you clean up a lot when you have or when you play Mizukis. In this specific combo, I'm gonna have Shiranui Solitaire. You can have Unizombie, but you need another zombie monster in your graveyard initially, and you're also going to need Mizuki in your hand. Now, you can make this a three-card combo with Zombie World or... you can make this a three-card combo with Zombie World to make the combo a little bigger, but I'm going to show you the two-card combo first and then extend it with the three-card combo. First, what you are going to do is normal summon your Shiranui Solitaire using its effect, True Tribute itself, to make the Unizombie. Unizombie's effect is going to send... Alright, ladies and gentlemen, so this card combo is basically why I play Gozuki. Gozuki has so many applications into the deck, but it allows you to actually balance out drawing Mizukis or bad Mizukis. In this particular sequence, it's a two or three card combo. The third card is Zombie World. It makes the combo a lot better, if you ask me, but the only two card combo is having Shiranui Solitaire and, of course, that bricky Mizuki in your hand. You don't necessarily need Solitaire. You can have the Unizombie in your hand, but you do need a zombie monster in the graveyard if you initially have Unizombie. So what you're going to do is summon your Shiranui Solitaire using its effect to tribute itself to summon your Unizombie to your side of the field. Use pardon me, Unizombie's effect to send Gozuki to the graveyard, and then Gozuki's effect banishing the Solitaire to special summon the Mizuki to your side of the field. Now, if you had a Shiranui Spirit Master also banished, then you'd be able to trigger the Solitaire to summon it, and then the combos just get even bigger if you ask me. But use the Mizuki and the Unizombie for a Synchro Summon into your Psyframe Lord Omega, and then activate your zombie, oh, I'm sorry, not activate your zombie world, and then use Omega's effect to banish a card from your opponent's side of the field. From there, you can use Mizuki's effect to banish itself to summon Gozuki to your side of the field, and then Gozuki, depending on your hand sequence, can send whatever card you need to the graveyard to get you more combos. So hypothetically, if you had a card in your hand, you could send another Mizuki to the graveyard, summon Unizombie through Mizuki, and then banish it or do whatever to summon another level 8 or Vampire Sucker if you guys played it. But since I don't play any level 8s, I would probably in this situation use it to send Necro or Banshee to get the Zombie World. Now for the 3-card combo, if you guys just so happen to already have the Zombie World, which is not impossibly hard to do, activate your Zombie World and then use Gozuki's effect, sending Gloom to the graveyard, triggering Gloom Bloom's effect to special summon that Doom King Baldurick to your, or Baladrok to your side of the field. Use both your Gozuki and your Baladrok as a Link Summon into your Vampire Sucker, and then on your opponent's turn, of course, special summon that Baladrok to your side of the field, giving you one card in your hand. That's how you rip one card out of your opponent's hand, be able to summon your Baladrok Vampire Sorcerer's combo with Zombie World, as well as have a Psyframe Boy Lore Omega for later turns. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is the 2-card combo you have all been waiting for. It's actually the reason why I like decided to go against Dangers, why I decided to play Pure, or against playing Pure, why I decided to play any other variant than the Revengerant monsters, is because this 2-card combo gets you so much advantage. The only 2 cards you're going to need is Pre-Preparation of Raich and Shiranui Solitaire. Coincidentally, you can just make it a 3-card combo by having Revengerant Slayer and Origin in your hand, as well as the Solitaire. What you're going to do is activate your Pre-Preparation of Raich to add your Slayer and your your Origin from your deck to your hand. Go ahead and normal summon your Shiranui Solitaire, tributing it to special summon Unizombie to your side of the field. Use the ability of Unizombie to send Shiranui Spirit Master from your deck to your graveyard, and then activate Revengerant Origin. Origin's going to allow you to banish zombie monsters from your graveyard, so bye-bye Spirit Master and Solitaire to special summon Slayer to my side of the field. Since they were both banished simultaneously, I can activate both of their effects. Spirit Master to destroy one of my opponent's monsters, and Solitaire to special summon Spirit Master to my side of the field. Use both Shiranui Spirit Master and Revengerant Slayer for a Link Summon into Vampire Suck Girl, triggering the effect of your Revengerant Slayer to send Vengerant Strigus to the graveyard to add Revengerant Evolution. Now, Strigus' effect is going to activate special summoning itself to the side of the field and triggering Vampire Sucker's effect. Draw a card, ladies and gentlemen. Use the effect of Revengerant Evolution, sending Revengerant Slayer to the graveyard to summon Vengerant Slayer to your side of the field. From there, you guys can use the Strigus and the Unizombie for a Synchro Summon into your Stardust Charge Warrior, ladies and gentlemen. Draw another card through Stardust Charge Warrior. You're also going to use your Stardust Charge Warrior and your Revengerant Slayer for the Exceed Summon into Beatrice the Eternal Lady, sending Revengerant Slayer to the graveyard to send a Necro World Banshee. Let me get the Banshee real quick. Banshee's gonna banish herself to allow you to activate Zombie World from your deck to your side of the field. And then on your opponent's turn, you're gonna use Beatrice's effect again, sending to the graveyard your Stardust Charge Warrior to send your Doom King Baladrok to the graveyard. On your opponent's standby phase, Doom King Baladrok's effect activates to special summon itself to the side of the field, and Vampire Sucker will allow you to draw a 3rd card. If you guys started off with 5 cards, you now have 6 cards in your hand. If you added with any 3 cards like Rivalry of the Warlords, I just don't see your opponent getting out of a 5-card hand, a Rivalry of the Warlords, Beatrice the Eternal Lady with no materials, but if you guys do play the Dante, she'll get destroyed and give you the Dante, Baladrick with the free negations, Vampire Sucker. It's just a lot for your opponent to overcome, especially since you have a full hand just waiting as if you went second. Thank you guys so much for watching another segment of the Cali Effect. There are some cards that I did not get to talk about, such as Zombie Master, Goblin Goblin Zombie, Beast of the Pharaoh, all of them are pretty good cards. But the problem with this deck is too many normal summons. 5 to 6 should be your max in any deck build, unless your deck can just plop out normal summons like it's crazy. If you guys have any questions, comments, or concerns, or just any opinions, post down below in the comment section. Please like, comment, subscribe, but most of all, enjoy. I hope you guys are having a great day like I am.